What is Runa? Runa means debt. We have five debts. Pitru Runa means debt of ancestors. Deva Runa means debt of devatas, deities. Rushi Runa means debt of rishis. Matru Runa, then we have debt of animals, Prani Runa. Then Manushya Runa means debt for human beings. For our living, we borrow from all this. So devatas or deities are responsible for running the universe. That rains and sunshine and our ability to see, hear, all this come from devatas. So gratitude to them is worshipping puja, doing puja and yadna, and taking care of the environmental activities, gratitude to deities, devatas. Then gratitude to ancestors is, they have given us life and they have struggled to bring up our life. So we have to bring up good children who are productive to this country, who are able to contribute to society. That's called Pitruna. Then also we have to perform the Shraddha and other rituals for them. Or you take care of senior citizens, or take care of other children. Somewhere you have to take care of the debt of ancestors. Pitruna. Manushirana means we take help from so many people. So help somebody who is in need. The help is of two types. One is called Dana and another is called Yadna. Dana means to give something. Yadna means to sow something. If you give a fish to somebody, it's called
Dana.
But if you teach fishing to somebody, it's called Yadna. So when you teach somebody, the teaching is not that for the person. From that, it will propagate. That's called Yadna. So Dana and Yadna is the way you can contribute to society, human beings. Then Rushi Runa is, since time immemorial, the Dana, Indians have given importance to teaching. The teaching comes from one generation to other generation, other generation to other generation, master to disciple. Thousands of years it has continued. Every generation will pass on the teaching to next generation, very faithfully. The teaching of Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, Brahma Sutra, Vedanta, all those teachings are preserved and passed on. Thanks to them, thousands of year old teaching also is preserved here. Otherwise, India has gone through very bad times, more than 1,000 years of war, disturbance. Even in that disturbance, the teaching has passed on because of this contribution. So that is the reason. How do you repay the Rishi Rana? Listen to the teaching of Rishi, understand it and pass it on to next generation. That's exactly why I have come to Mysore. Rushi Runa, whatever I have received from Rishis, I am learning and I am passing it on. This is called Rushi Runa. Out of the five Runa, Rushi Runa is the highest because that's wisdom. Then Prani Runa or Bhuta Runa is we are supported by so many living beings. Our survival depends on so many other animals. Today we are torturing animals, harassing animals, immense suffering we are causing to animals. Forget about causing suffering, we are supposed to do service to them, seeing God in all. So that's called Bhutaruna. So these are called five debts and how to repay them. Okay. So Aita, next question is Dhyan Madhuna.
One question.